Thanks for coming today. We're going to just have a chat about the ways that we might look at the Year 10 English programs using data that we have collected to evaluate what we're teaching and what the specific needs of our kids are and how we might differentiate our programs in order to cater for the individual needs of the students. I'm Scylla Doyle. I'm the Dean of Studies at St Philip's Christian College, Port Stephens. What do you think of some of the things that we might have?
PAT assessments.
Yep. So prepared assessment tasks, that's one thing, which we don't really have at the beginning of the year. So what are we going to use?
NAPLAN. We've got detailed results.
So we've got quite detailed NAPLAN results. Are there other things that we might use to look at specific needs of our kids? The session today was necessary because having looked at the English programs that were in place, I was aware that they were very generic programs that did not take into account any of the specific learning needs of the students.
The students often know their strengths and weaknesses. So if we can say to them, I've identified their strengths with you, do you agree? And they'll probably be very honest and open, or they seem to be so far. And then you say, I think we need to work on this particular aspect and we're aiming to get you your personal best, you know, a couple more marks, we can do this. I think that's helpful.
Well, I think information that we gain from parents, yep. I know that can be pretty particularly valuable.
What they actually know about their students that they don't realise is data that they can use in preparing their programs, resources that they can use, for example, parents, teaching staff that had the students earlier on, NAPLAN results, the different sorts of things we know about what our students can and can't do. I want to have a little look at the NAPLAN results for 2011. Now, as far as the state is concerned, we don't do too badly. I am particularly concerned about our results compared to the region and to the section. If you look at the spelling column for the band 10s, 1.8 compared to 10.3 in the region.
Wow.
Got any comments about reading and writing?
Band 9, reading and writing responses are both substantially lower.
Yeah. We're doing okay in the middle. But we're not doing well at the top. We're not extending our kids in that top.
And that is a pattern. That's a pattern that we've found reflected across school certificate and high school certificate. Spelling in particular is a very weak area across the school. Punctuation and grammar are things that our students are probably not strong at implementing in their writing. Really, adjectives kept coming up. It really surprised me.
And it's interesting that you say that you expected they would have learned about it, because that first one, identifies an adjective, is actually a stage two outcome. Mm. Maybe wasn't taught that well when they were in primary school, and because the teachers, as the children get older, assume that they have this knowledge already. If it's been missed earlier on, it just seems to get skipped over all the time. So.
It's one thing to encourage insightful thinking, but then they need to represent that in by following the mechanics of language.
So where do we go from here?
Well, it needs to be rewritten according and with a particular class in mind rather than a generic.
Yep. I think that also is something that's desperately needed. So the teachers will go away and review their programs and come up with some strategies, and then Michael will coordinate those programs. At the end of the term, we will re-evaluate, collect some more data on the students, do some assessment and see whether or not those strategies are actually working in improving the learning outcomes for the students in the classes. Thank you very much. Meeting closed.
How do you lead colleagues to evaluate the effectiveness of learning and teaching programs to ensure specific learning needs of students are being met? How can you lead and influence others to improve teaching practice based on student performance?